This is a video on Stokes' theorem. The question states, use Stokes' theorem to find the line integral over a curve C of f dot dr, where C is the triangle with vertices 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 3, and 1, 2, 4, oriented positively, and f is the vector field, f of x, y, z, is equal to 2y plus sine of x times I plus y minus z squared times j plus e to the z times k. So let's first recall Stokes' theorem that tells us that the line integral over a curve oriented positively of f dot dr is equal to the surface integral over a surface whose boundary is that curve of the curl of f dot n ds. So let's find the curl of f. And the curl of f is the determinant to the matrix I, j, k, del over del x, del over del y, del over del z, 2y plus sine of x, y minus z squared, and e to the z. So I take that determinant. For the I component, I get del over del y of e to the z, which is 0, minus del over del z of y minus z squared. So we get 0 minus a negative 2z, which is positive 2z. So I get 2zi. For the j component, del over del x of e to the z is 0, and del over del z of 2y plus sine of x is also 0. So the j component is just 0. And for the k component, I get del over del x of y minus z squared, that's 0, minus del over del y of 2y plus sine of x, and that's 2. So I get negative 2k. So the curl of f is equal to 2zi minus 2k. So now let's find the equation of the plane that contains this triangle. And to do that, I need to find the normal vector for the plane. So I take the cross product of the first displacement vector, which is 1, 1, 3, and the second displacement vector, which is 1, 2, 4. So I work that cross product out. I have I, j, k, 1, 1, 3, 1, 2, 4. And what I got was negative 2i minus j plus k. So the normal vector dotted with the displacement vector should always be 0. And I can let the displacement vector go from 0, 0, 0 to x, y, z and say that negative 2, comma, negative 1, comma, 1 dotted with x, y, z is equal to 0. And when I dot those, I get negative 2x minus y plus z equals 0, or z is x plus 2y. So now let's look at the surface, or this plane that contains the three points, and look at its shadow in the xy plane. So that means I ignore the z coordinate and just look at the xy coordinate, 0, 0, 1, 1, and 1, 2. So that will be a triangle in the xy plane with those three points, and the line connecting 0, 0, and 1, 1 is y equals x. The line connecting 0, 0, and 1, 2 is y equals 2x. So for the double integral, the little man's feet are on y equals x, the little man's head is on y equals 2x, the farthest to the left the little man can get is 0, and the farthest to the right the little man can get is 1. So I can say that the surface integral is equal to the double integral x equals 0 to 1, y equals x to y equals 2x, and then we have the curl of f, so that was 2zi, and z is x plus 2y, so I get 2 times x plus 2y times I, then minus 2k, so there's my minus 2k, dotted with, and then we take negative g sub x, that's negative I, and then negative g sub y, so we have minus 2j, then plus k. And we always have dy dx because we're integrating with respect to y first and then x. So let's take the dot product. This, by the way, is 2x plus 4y times negative 1, or negative 2x minus 4y. Then we have negative 2 times positive 1. So we get negative 2x minus 4y minus 2. And this integral is not too difficult, but I worked it out by a calculator to save a little time. And what I got was negative 11 thirds. So I can conclude that the line integral over C of f dot dr is equal to negative 11 thirds. And I'm done with the problem.